Hi guys, a very warm welcome. Today we're going to be discussing retirement. Actually, over the next few weeks, we're going to be discussing retirement. However, what I'd like to focus on today is more retirement in terms of what I've done and the mistakes that I've made and things that I wish I'd known when I was first starting and sort of, yeah, you know, when I first started working, which was a couple of years ago, very many years ago, almost 10 years ago, actually. I had a very, you know, it was one of those office jobs and I didn't really earn much, but part of it didn't, you know, the job didn't include benefits. So there was no medical aid, there was no retirement benefits. And, you know, at the time I thought I was very young and I thought I had enough time to get to a point where that would be a benefit. So I didn't bother trying to plan for retirement or save anything or invest anything. I was just like, nope, it's fine. I've got plenty of time, so I'm just gonna put that off. And so I think, you know, when I think back and I look at the mistakes that I've made when it comes to my retirement planning, I'd say that was probably the first, not starting early enough. And the second was when I did eventually start saving, and that wasn't out of choice. It was an obligation. I got a job and it was a permanent job, and part of the benefits included medical aid and saving for retirement or retirement pension fund. And what happened there is I sort of didn't really, you know, want to save because I kept on thinking I could do doing so many things with this money and I really, really don't want to save it. So we had a choice about how much we could contribute. There was a minimum and a maximum amount that we could contribute. And obviously I went for the lowest amount possible because I thought I need all the extra money. In retrospect, yeah, that probably wasn't a wise decision. And I do regret that incredibly. Subsequently, as I have managed to sort of go through my financial journey and clean up my finances, my mindset has changed a lot about retirement planning. And I remember when I signed my latest permanent employment contract, I actually managed to work out that, you know, if I contribute as much as possible, this would be the benefit, you know. So I did that. And that was very, I mean, it did hurt to see, you know, that money sort of not coming into my disposable income, but I had a better understanding of why it was important to save, so it didn't hurt as much as it used to. And I suppose one of the most dangerous things or one of the biggest assumptions I made when I first started saving for retirement was thinking I had all the time in the world and I was saving enough. And that is totally untrue. And, you know, I sat down, did the maths, and I was like, oh my goodness, I'm actually not. And will I be able to live on this amount, you know, later on in my life? And, you know, that sort of put me in a panic and sort of moved me to then get a retirement annuity outside my work provident fund that I contribute to. The other thing that really helped boost my retirement savings was the introduction of a tax-free savings account. And I thought, finally, you know, here was an investment vehicle that would allow me to get a really great tax benefit and allow me to save long term. And there were benefits, and you know, the whole penalty and penalizing system works perfectly for me because it incentivizes me to preserve my retirement savings in a tax-free savings account, but also makes me think very carefully about the type of tax-free savings account that I take out and how long I have to sort of reap that benefit. So, you know, for me, tax-free savings accounts are really, really great and they're like awesome. So where I'm at now, you know, I'm still in a bit of a panic mode about how much I'm saving. I don't feel like I'm saving enough. But I also find myself in a position where I sort of have to compromise. I'm a lot freer about how much I do save. So I'm investing a lot more than I was 5 years ago, for instance. I'm putting a lot more into tax-free savings. I've got a tax-free savings account for my son. And that, I think, has helped me a lot in terms of understanding the importance of why I need to be doing this for myself, for my son, and for everyone involved, you know. The last thing I want is to become a burden for my to my son. How do I feel? I mean, and that I suppose plays a really big role in how much I'm saving. Sometimes I feel like, there are times, guys, when all I want is to buy a pair of shoes, a really nice pair of shoes. But I've come to understand the importance of safeguarding my future. So while, saving now for later isn't as fun as I'd like it to be, it's a very important part of my financial planning. And, I understand the trade-off and I understand the benefits of it. And, I look at people in my life, in my experience, be they family members or friends of family, whatever the case is, and I look at the trouble that they're going through and sort of because they haven't saved enough for their financing, I mean for their tax, sorry, retirement. Wow. It makes me feel a lot better about how much I'm saving. But, then you also think about all the other things you could be doing and you're like, oh, I could be going to Morocco, but I'm saving for retirement. So it's not without, its little tugging at heartstrings, But it's not bad, It's not something that I feel incredibly like I really, really, really don't want to do this. I understand the benefits of it, so I'm okay doing it. And I'm really hoping that over the next few weeks, I'll be able to sort of impress and share the importance of saving for retirement, the benefit of saving for retirement, and sort of looking at different retirement saving vehicles and understanding them. So, what's the difference between a provident fund, a pension fund, and a retirement annuity? And why you need to think about these differences, and then looking at tax-free savings products that could be able to sort of help you choose and weigh the benefits of the different products that are out there and make your decision based on those. But for today, I'm really glad that I could share my little journey. Obviously there's a lot more I think I need to learn and do in terms of saving for my retirement. Every now and then, something new hits me, I get a new insight, or I'll come across an article and I'll be like, oh my goodness, I actually did not factor this into my retirement planning. So it's always great to be learning and sort of getting new insights, and I look forward to sharing those with you over the next couple of weeks. Other than that, have a great day and happy retirement saving.